I felt like if they just chop off the old part.
She says that again.
It will be. It
say
will
that
be
again,
a great
Susie.
Movie.
I can't take it.
Are you joking?
We are back. No laughing.
No laughing. No fun.
We're going to review a movie. It's supposed to be a comedy, so no laughing.
Okay. Welcome back. So we're continuing on our Halloween special. We've come to the last movie, and that is my movie, which is The Frozen Empire Ghostbusters. I'm saying it that way because it didn't give it to me when I said Ghostbusters Frozen Empire. So anyway. The first Ghostbusters was a huge success, and it really was complete within itself. And I really have a trouble with a lot of, something's complete within itself. It's like it's kind of like you were talking about the Joker, the second one. And remember, things were resolved. He came into himself. And now the second one, he's back to being the depressed person again. So it's kind of like they're kind of a letdown because they kind of nixed.
You know, like Bob was saying, these are movies that are one movie.
Yes, they're complete within themselves.
Like my movie.
yeah, they're complete. They're and you use it like Matrix. It was like, it's complete within itself. So that was one of the problems for me with this film. I actually enjoyed the second one. I thought they took it somewhere else and they kind of made it different. And I thought this one.
The second one, you mean the.
Oh, yeah. You're talking about like Ghostbusters Afterlife?
Two. Yeah, Afterlife.
Being the
Afterlife.
Third one.
I like that one.
That's the third one.
Well, this one with all the women, too.
No, so. Yeah, that's the one with the women.
I think I'm in a minority here. I don't.
That was
think...
called Wokebusters.
Wokebusters, yeah.
And we canceled.
I think on the third movie, if I was making the movie, I would have separated, since that's what the second movie did, the old gang from the new gang, and you could go on with the new movie, but they keep bringing the... it just... Too much weight on the movie. Like there's the whole bunch of people.
I have to interrupt here because you're going to really confuse people by calling it the first and the second movie. There's Ghostbusters. There's Ghostbusters 2. Then there's Ghostbusters Afterlife. Then there's Ghostbusters the Frozen Empire.
The one where they went to the country.
No. See, that's Afterlife. That's why we actually said you're talking about Ghostbusters Afterlife. She said
that's
yes.
That's
what she's referring to when she says the first movie.
Right. So, no, the second movie.
You mean
Frozen Empire is the second movie.
It's the third movie.
The second movie is Ghostbusters 2. The first movie is
What's
Ghostbusters.
The first movie is just Ghostbusters.
Yeah,
if you don't count the one with all the women.
Well, no, it's just when you say the first one.
I don't count that one.
Okay. So there's four movies altogether, not three.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. This is the fourth.
Okay, so I'm talking about where they went to the country.
Afterlife.
Just say
Afterlife.
Yeah.
We could just use the names of the movies.
I thought that was great.
I did too.
Right? They kind of the same thing. They took something good and they changed it. They brought it somewhere different. And I thought that they were going to now introduce this new group of people, which I thought were great. I thought the... Kids were great, and their associates were great. I thought it was great. Okay, so because it's my movie, I kind of got to explain to you the basic
premise
of the movie. So the film was kind of way too complicated for me. The basic story is the Spangler family, right, is now back. And they're in New York. They have taken over the old firehouse. And the opening scene, they are chasing spectral creatures in the old Ecto-1 with new high-tech gear developed by Phoebe, who's McKenna Grace. The science brain kid, who is now 15. The old crew is still around. Bill Murray as Venkman, Dane Aykroyd as Stance, and Ernie Hudson as Zeddemore.
Winston.
Zeddemore.
Winston.
Winston, yeah.
Winston Zeddemore is his name, but yeah. Megan Winston is going to be easier.
I use last name. We're in last name.
Keep it official.
Yeah. Who is actually the most grounded of them all? He's like kind of grounded. Paul Rudd has now joined the Spangler family and is actively trying to fit in as a stepfather. Not having a lot of luck. It's not working out. Anyways, there is this ancient artifact that has an evil entity that threatens to bring about the worldwide ice age, and the old Ghostbusters and the new generation of Ghostbusters must join forces to save the world from a second ice age. That's the story. And there's a lot of jokes. There's a lot of that, but that's basically the story. I found it way too complicated, way too heavy. The past and the present and the future, you need to get rid of one of those. I feel the past needs to get rid. They're not necessary. The kids themselves could do it. You know, they have developed their characters enough. And that's all I got to say about it.
Okay.
It was, of all the movies, we did some great movies for this Halloween special. I loved all the movies except this one. I didn't.
I loved this movie. I thought it was a great kids movie. It was a great kids movie. And I love that they bring Bill Murray, Dan Aykroyd. I love that they bring the past to the present. It's a nice interplay. I thought how they did the first two Ghostbusters movies and the last two, to do that crossover, that's really hard to do. But they did it. And I think, yeah, I thought it was, you know, it's light, you know, it's a kids movie. So, yeah, I liked it a lot.
Okay.
Oh, wow. Well, I'm with you, Patty. I enjoyed the movie, too, for what it was. I just thought, at first I thought, okay, this looks like a real dud. And I would say the first half hour, I was not excited about it. But it was using the characters from the past that I thoroughly enjoyed. That gave me some, I think, oh, you know.
Right.
Especially, you know, people like, I can't even remember his name, the guy who plays the mayor. William Atherton.
Him. Yeah.
You know, the fact that he showed up right away, it's like, okay, you know exactly where he's at. But even to see, you know, the whole cast, like you had said, you know, including Annie Potts, I really like that.
Me too.
Meet myself. But I was sort of disappointed with the story because to me, it's, again, saving New York. You know, oh, monster's coming. Ghostbusters have to kill all the things in New York. And it's like, oh my God, really? So I had to admit, for me, it was really the cast that made me go along. So the young, Finn Wolfhard and McKenna Grace, I think, are wonderful actors in this movie. Paul Rudd and Carrie Coon, I thought, were fine for what they're doing. I didn't find them really outstanding, but they're not supposed to be. They're supposed to be playing parents, and I think that's what they do well. Because I think that you're right, that this is more aimed at kids.
Yeah, totally.
So when kids are watching this, they say, yeah, the parents are really trying to be good parents kind of thing. I thought that was sort of nice. I like that Logan Kim playing the friend who's always podcasting.
Yeah.
But it was things like...
I like him.
Yeah, but it was
I like the kids a lot.
No, that's what I mean. I can see the new generation coming up. But, you know, it was what really started hooking me is when Dan Aykroyd is doing this podcast thing and I'm cracking up thinking, how perfect. Yeah. That's so perfect for Dan Aykroyd, you know? He's got it, and I love what this... Tell them to subscribe and like.
Yes, remember. Subscribe and like.
When he's knowing Kim break the things, goes, that's what sells. Exactly. It gives us more views.
Exactly. But it really kicks in for me is when you're right about the artifact that Kumail Nanjiani, or Nanjiani, what is his name, shows up to sell. Again, I've always found him, ever since he's been on the scene, this guy, I'm always entertained by now.
Yeah, he is. He's good.
He can shorthand humor so quickly now to me. So it's like, it was wonderful to him.
Oh, he was great.
You know, and then you had people like Patton Oswalt showing up in little bits. And
Patton Oswalt,
one part I liked was James Acaster. He's the one who plays this Lars character. And the only reason is like, he's a British stand-up. That's the only, like, and he wasn't even particularly funny.
He
wasn't particularly funny, but he was good. Exactly. Yeah. So it is nice to see these new people start coming into it. In fact, I hope they keep Kumail Nanjiani in the next movie, because I'd love to see what he's capable of that he's become. What exactly did he become? Like the guardian of the orb, I guess, or something, right? Those guardians. But you're right. See, that's part of the lore. That's like, can this happen? But now you're thinking, well, where are they going to go, though? They can't keep saving New York, because I think that's the problem. I think what they had with the woke busters, like you said, that the women, they basically had to do the same movie as the first one.
But you can save somebody at humankind anywhere.
No, exactly. And that's why I said, I think New York needs the money and the film crews and everything. I want them to still film in New York, but I would like their adventures, because I think that's what made it nice about the thing in Oklahoma, that they're out of New York. They're in, like I said, more the Midwest.
Yes.
Right. They're on a farm, right?
Yeah,
That added a nice little difference. At least it was different from what you're saying.
I think maybe.
This was more, the same in a way.
Right. Because I'm Los Angeles, I'm really, really don't like New York. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of like, I don't have the emotional, like, it's attachment. Like, okay.
Yeah. I don't care where they film.
I think Los Angeles would be perfect because of just like the.
It would be so funny.
The self-involved.
Exactly.
That would be very
advanced
funny.
Advanced consciousness. So.
Oh, and the fact that, like I said, it's like, how many ghosts are buried in this city?
It's kind of a Hollywood cemetery.
I liked.
You're just trying to make some money for Scott Michaels.
Nanjiani. Mm-hmm. I liked him through the movie. I didn't like what they wrote for him at the end, but up till that point, I really liked him. But like I said, I had no problem with the new people.
Mm-hmm.
I have a lot of problems with the old people. It's like, they need to retire gracefully. That's how I felt.
Right. George's turn.
Wait.
No, sorry. Yeah.
Yeah, so yeah, this movie, I really loved Afterlife. I thought the Afterlife was made for adults. This one, I think, is made for maybe 11-year-olds. You know? If you think of it that way, then it kind of makes sense. The kind of reparative story. The two people that really got me, carried me through the movie was Logan Kim. He was just cracking me up the whole time. Because he was in the first one, too.
Yeah.
And Kumail Nanjiani, he cracks me up because he's...
And when you say the first one, you mean the third one.
That's right.
Afterlife.
He cracked me up in Afterlife, and he kept cracking me in this one. He's just like, he's just so funny. Like, both of them, to me, have great comedy. They were the comedy relief, I guess, you would say that in the movie, those two characters.
It's funny to think of two characters as being the comedy relief in a comedy.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. they both kept cracking me up. Like you, I thought they could have written a little better things for Nanjiani, but I don't know how much he improvised himself, how much he wrote himself.
You know. I was going to say, and okay, I'll give you the Dan Aykroyd in the podcast. You could have kept that part, but you don't need to keep bringing to me these characters, they've done their job. The new characters are great.
In fact, what I hope they do, to be quite honest, the way they would use them is that's the resource. You need, what about this? You know to go to Ray because he knows certain things. You know to go to Venkman because he knows certain things.
They're like the wise experts that you, right.
But I like the fact that you're right about the Zeddemore thing, because that's how they were referring to him, as Dr. Zeddemore, not Winston, because now he has a company.
Yes, he's incorporated
and it's a business of Ghostbusters. So
I have to see it more like if I'm watching a movie that is more for children and you're taking the kids or the family or whatever, and then it's really for them. It has some funny parts, but I will say I enjoy the Afterlife better than this one. It was still entertaining, but I thought they could have written a better story with it, because the ghost started to get a little predictable. I keep seeing the green guy and all still, but I need a more complex.
They can drop the green guy.
Too. Yeah, I need a more complex bad ghost. You know. A more complicated thing.
Hmm.
Don't you think this ghost was a little more complicated? I'll go. Okay.
No, but, no. Are you talking about the girl? Or are you talking about the ice guy?
The ice guy. He was a little more complicated.
And scarier, I think. Yeah,
but you know the little puff. Dough people.
The Stay Puff.
Oh my God, that was so funny. That was funny.
That's what I want to have my mug. I forgot to take on my mug.
It reminded me of what is that? Goonies? No, not Goonies.
Gremlins. Gremlins. It reminded me of Gremlins.
Yes. Yeah. Gremlins. No, they kind of behave like Gremlins. Gremlins. They kind of just were like naughty.
Yeah.
They were doing naughty. They're just naughty. Okay. Oh, you finished, George? Yes. I'm sorry.
Okay. You know what? It just occurred to me when we were talking about this. What they should do is get in Bill Hader and Fred Armisen and new Saturday Night Live people.
Oh, God, but they're all so horrible. They're all so horrible. We want funny people.
Well, well, just because you don't know what's funny doesn't mean we can't have them.
I have a great sense of humor.
Well, this is funny for a new generation.
Just ask her.
So,
but it's like keeping the legend of the Ghostbusters was a Saturday Night Live movie.
Absolutely.
The second one, one of the problems with the second one was the funniest character was not one of the originals. It was like Peter McNichol playing the crazy scientist, and I mean, it was like. It was either annoying or whatever, but he was funnier than the other people in that movie.
I don't think so. I disagree with that.
Well, yeah, but
it would be great that.
What can I say?
It's not your turn. No,
Martin Short and Steve Martin would have been great.
No, not Martin Short and Steve Martin. No, no. But you know, to like do something that's making a reference back to where this came from in the first place. The new people, I mean, that's one of the things that was shocking to me is that Paul Rudd wasn't funny in this movie. No, I see wasn't. Paul Rudd in a movie, I expect to scream my ass off. He's so funny.
Yeah, mm-hmm. That's true.
Paul Rudd and Scott, and what's his name? Scott William Thomas or whatever his name is. Sean William Scott and Paul Rudd together are hysterically funny. Get those guys in there. Get people who are.
If we get rid of the mother, he's not.
Well, I guess I've gotten rid of her because I don't even remember. I mean, I know.
She is a great actor. You've seen her in a million things and you don't recognize her because.
Well, her name is kind of familiar, but I can't peg her. Paul Rudd is a guy who is authentically funny.
Yeah,
he wasn't given anything to do and be funny in that movie.
But I don't think he was supposed to be.
None of the adults were funny.
No, I don't think they were supposed to be.
Yeah. And as far as the kids go, I mean, Finn Wolfhard I thought was really good in Stranger Things. And I like the fact that they're tying it into Stranger Things. But this was just, this movie didn't even just sit there. It sank.
I didn't find it sinking, but.
There was just nothing.
I agree. It's heavy. That's what I said.
Nothing funny about it. It was like a ghost story that wasn't scary, a comedy that wasn't funny. Afterlife was really, and as Susie pointed out, they took it out of New York.
Who cares? I didn't even notice we're there. Why?
I knew, or I wouldn't be bringing it up.
Because they introduced new characters.
Didn't they even have a miniature Stay Puft Man in this thing, too?
Yes. They had lots of them.
Lots of them. And they were very funny.
What the hell? Yeah. I'm bleeding. Oh, no, it must be chocolate.
They're the same color.
Halloween, folks.
You're bleeding chocolate? I think I'm going to be a vampire.
So it just was, I don't know. I mean, I
so did you like it or you didn't like it?
No, I didn't Ghostbusters Frozen Empire, I really like that title. There's something about the Frozen Empire that's really getting
that's
to me.
That's a good
and
title.
I just sat there and went, where's the scares? Where's the funny? Where's everything? Where's the movie? There's no there.
Isn't it funny how some of us can like, and this goes with mankind, period, can just love a movie and others can just not like it at all. I just find that really interesting.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I
love you, honey.
It's not that I didn't think the movie was, it's not like I don't think the future is irredeemable. I felt like if they just chop off the old part,
she says that again.
It will be a great movie.
I can't take it.
Well, if you look at old Saturday Night Live stuff, Dan Aykroyd was so funny. He's not funny anymore.
I disagree. I find him
I don't think he's a particularly good actor. I don't think he's very funny anymore.
Well, he's not an actor.
Oh, no, he isn't. He's an actor. No, he's an actor. He's a comic actor. And you just look at the...
I have seen him do non-comedic.
But I'm not talking about non-comedic. I'm saying like that when you look at like Fred Garvin, male prostitute, some of that stuff he was doing on the first season of Saturday Night Live was really good acting.
But that's a skit. A skit is different than a movie.
No, then Christopher Guest will start writing those stories.
Yeah, maybe.
No, they don't.
Well, I'm interested to hear the countdown.
Yes.
Okay.
I wish you.
So, have you finished, or is there more to
say? Oh, I'll stop.
I'll stop
because of her. She's just going to knock any guy.
Don't listen to her. I agree with you. I am on your side.
Okay, well, then I'll stop because of you. Yeah. Okay. I'm not going to top that.
Okay.
So. I give it an 8.
I gave it a 5.
I give it a 5.
You make it sound like that's a good thing.
Oh, that is.
I give it a 3.
Oh,
wow.
Good for you.
Okay, so that ends our Halloween
extravaganza.
Yeah, exactly. And so remember, as they said, as Dan Aykroyd said, subscribe and like. And I hope you'll watch our movies and let us know what you think about them and suggest other movies.
Yeah.
So,
and our next show will be in 3D.
Yeah. These people are nuts. Okay.
Must be a full moon.
It's not.
Isn't it like a solar eclipse or something?
We've already had it.
Already had it. We don't have an excuse. Yeah. Just nuts.
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll see you next time. And thank you for joining us.
Happy Halloween.
Bye.
Happy Halloween.
Bye-bye.
Adios.
Oh, I'm sorry.